Praise the living God, dear heart. I am so thankful, God, that you enjoy Brother Ellis' biblical procedure for seeing Jesus face to face. I received a lot of comments, and praise the living God. So do as one sister did, dear heart. She wrote down all of the scripture around her. And you know, I could have, Brother Ellis did give me the scripture reference, but the Holy Ghost said no. You know, sometimes, dear heart, you have to do your own study. You know, when you're in school, the teacher's not going to do everything for you. There's something you have to do yourself. You must apply yourself. So this sister, she applied herself and wrote down all the scriptures. She got to the last scripture, and she thought Brother Ellis said Mark. But he actually said Matthew, and she found out it was in Matthew. So that showed me she searched the scriptures. In them, think you have eternal life, because we do, praise the living God. But we have to do our own searching. So I thank God that you are enjoying these testimonies. You know, don't be ashamed to share your testimony. Now, Brother Ellis is giving an example to you. You can do the same thing. God delivered you through this ministry. And you are doing marvelous things for the Lord, send me an audio recording. A video would be perfect, but if not, send me an audio recording to share what good thing God has done for you so I can share with others, you know, give them hope, encouragement. Look at Brother Ellis. You always see hope and encouragement. Right now, some of you stayed up last night waiting to see Jesus. And some of you saw Jesus. I want to hear. We want to hear about it. So, you know, there's no excuse. Just like Brother Ellis, you can use your telephone. You know, I got a great report this morning, dear heart, from the brother in Nigeria. His last deliverance session, he said, man, King, he said, I want to go out and minister the gospel of Jesus Christ in the marketplace. I said, just do it. He said, huh? I said, just do it. You have to just do it. God be with you. And by the time the Lord threw me finished, he had hope. He's like, I'm going to do it. You know what, dear heart? He did it. He sent me that message this morning. I said, Lord, now this is what I love to see. When I get up in the morning to open my email, I like to read that good news. Give me some good news first. Glory to his own name. And he was so excited. He said, man, King, I did. I went to the marketplace and preached Jesus. So he gave up his reputation, and he shared it. He said, I got attacked that night. In my dream, the devil attacked me, but the Lord gave me victory in the dream. I came out praising the Lord. I said, that's right, brother. No weapon formed against you shall prosper. I said, now remember, when you go out for Jesus is dealt with you. The scripture tells us that when the Lord sent out his disciples, the apostles, the scripture says Jesus was working with them. And that's by his Holy Spirit. So whatever we do for Jesus, he's right there working with us, even right now. He's right here working with me. Dear, I can't even talk to you if Jesus did not allow me to do it, if he did not enable me to do it. Stop taking things for granted. So he did it, and praise the living God. I said, next time, I said, first of all, you have an audio recording on your phone? He said, yeah. He said, I didn't have it turned on this morning, but the next time I would turn it on. I said, great, because I would love to hear it. Record it, so I can share it. And I give others hope to do the same. Now I'm going to share another testimony from Brother Ellis. This time it's from his sweet wife, Tawanna. Tawanna came first to be delivered. And then her husband saw what great thing God had done for her that he got delivered. Then the stepsons got delivered. And then Tawanna, ex-husband, ain't that awesome, dear heart? You see how our deliverance, salvation, healing, and whatever gift God gives us is tied up to somebody's else. So here the Lord working with her husband, Ellen, and showing people how they can see and encounter Jesus face to face. I guess she said, I'm going to try to. And dear heart, she saw Jesus in a dream. The Lord gave her a supernatural dream. Yeah, God do give us a supernatural dream. And when God gives a supernatural dream, dear heart, you won't be confused the next morning when you get up. You don't even have to think about interpretation because the Holy Spirit already given you the interpretation. Because that's how it is when God gives a supernatural dream. But in her supernatural dream, I love it. I love them all. But her supernatural dream, in the nutshell of that, is Jesus telling us to focus on him. Focus on Jesus. And God is the heart. So what we're going through, we keep focused on Jesus. Because he is soon to come. So I want you to listen to Tawanna, supernatural dream. In Jesus' name.
Okay, this is Ellis Thomas, and this is another face-to-face appearance by Jesus. And I'm here with my wife, Tawanna, and she had a visitation from Jesus and the Father. And here it is, and this is what she's got to say about her experience. So what happened in your visitation?
Well, I fell asleep one night, and I was praying and talking to God, and I think I was asleep maybe about 30 minutes, and all of a sudden, I had like, I was caught up to heaven, and when I noticed where I was in like a, what seemed like a coliseum, and there was a whole bunch of saints there. Everybody had on all of these beautiful white flowing robes, and the like a coliseum, it had like these, it had gold bars with gold pillars, and it was a huge stadium full of people dressed in white, surrounded by what seemed to be a stage with a throne, like a chair throne, sitting on the stage. And my attention was taken, like, traveled to the throne, and I was
so,
looking.
When you say your attention was taken, what do you mean your attention was taken?
I mean, like, focus, like my focus point. Like, I was made to focus point was, like, the focus, like my
on the throne.
Gaze was focused on the throne, yeah.
Okay.
And on that throne, I saw Jesus. First, he wasn't sitting on the throne. He was standing next to the throne.
And did you see his face, or, you know, was he in light, in his glory, or what was it?
He wasn't in light. He wasn't in, like, glory, like everybody see. What was, what I noticed was it was like a slow motion kind of me gazing from his leg, from his feet up mm-hmm. to his waist. Mm-hmm. And it kind of stopped there, like at his chest point.
Okay.
And then my gaze was focused to the sky around it.
How does his hair look?
His hair was brownish.
Mm-hmm.
He looked like a Hebrew.
Mm-hmm.
He had brown eyes.
Okay.
No beard. Looked like he was not old, but young, about 30-ish.
Mm-hmm.
And he had no smile, but a serious facial expression.
Wow. Okay.
When I looked into the sky, I saw the Father's throne, but his throne was the sky.
Wow, he was that big.
Yes.
Wow. So when you looked up at the sky, his throne and him sitting on it took the whole view of your eyes when you looked at the sky.
It was the sky.
Wow.
Surrounded in whitish gray clouds.
Mm.
And I didn't see his face, but he spoke out of that cloud.
Wow, how did his voice sound?
His voice sounded like thunder.
Thunder.
But it just spoke through you.
That's right.
Through you.
That's right.
Mm-hmm. Like if he spoke, it's like the wind would go through you. Mm-hmm. And you knew that was the Father speaking. And Jesus never said anything. The Father spoke for him. And he said, "This is my Son." And that every knee will bow and every tongue will confess
yes,
that my Son is Lord.
Amen.
And when that happened, all the people in the Colosseum just began to just fall down on their face.
Yes,
wow.
And bow before Jesus. And I was looking because I'm like trying to find a place for me to fall on the ground and worship him too. And I felt like I couldn't even get low, like the ground was too low to give him all the adoration. But my focus again was taken back to Jesus and his facial expression. He did not smile. He was not like proud, like he didn't even receive the worship, but he did something that was amazing that speaks of his character. He bowed back to the people.
Amen.
That just
took
my breath away because it was so like didn't humble.
Awesome. That sounds just like Jesus.
He bowed back before the people, and I saw he had on a white, I think it was white robe, but I was focused on the crown that he had on his head. Mm. He had a crown on his head, and it was purple, like royal red and gold, like royalty kind of crown. And once I was allowed to see his face and his crown, all of a sudden, the church was just raptured.
Wow.
And I found myself back on the earth looking for the Lord, saying, "What happened?" Then this Bible just came from heaven and fell open in my hand. And the Lord spoke out of the clouds and said, "I want you to preach my word." And then I was back in my bed.
Wow, what an awesome, awesome, awesome testimony. That is amazing. So, when you were in heaven in the Colosseum, so you came back to earth, and when you came back, before you got back down, they were raptured up.
Yes.
And everybody was gone while you had came back.
Those who were in the Colosseum, they were going to the marriage supper of the Lamb.
They were going to the marriage supper of the Lamb. Wow. How awesome is that? Glory to God. Well, that is Tawanna's face-to-face visitation by Jesus and the Father. And is there anything else you want to add? Well, I hope that encourages everyone to make sure they start getting themselves ready for this rapture that's going to come up. Jesus is doing some amazing things to gather that remnant and his bride together. We're coming close to it. It's about to happen. So get ready. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen, Jehovah. Amen. You know, Jesus wants to stay focused. Stay focused on him because he is returning. But in the meantime, we are still on this earth. He said, "Preach my word." That means open your mouth and speak truth. That's preaching the word of God. I know you're looking at it being behind a pulpit. No, it's simply open your mouth and speak truth. A lot of times you're around other people and they speaking falsely and you won't say a word. You just keep your mouth closed. And the Holy Ghost is unctioning you. Say something. Speak truth, correct them, and from a loving heart, but you still won't do it. So that's what it means when the Lord said, "Preach my word." Preach means to talk, to speak. put vocalization to it. Speak truth, because Jesus is soon to come. It don't matter where we are. Truth who is in us, who is Christ Jesus, he said, I am truth. And then the words that come out of our mouth, that comes from our heart, it would be truth. Share the goodness of God. Share with your family, with your friends, so-called friends, other loved ones, and whoever, strangers, whoever. You share the goodness of God. Let them know how God loved them. Especially come to you, complain about their circumstances. You can tell them, look, there's a way out of that. They need to hear about Jesus. See, Jesus wants us to stay focused on him. And we stay focused on him 24/7, dear heart. Wow. We would be doing amazing exploits for God. So I thank God for that supernatural dream they gave my sister Tawanna. It's a blessing to us all. God is not just didn't tell her to preach his word. He's telling all of us to preach his word, which means to speak truth. Again, stop looking at it as going behind a forehead. Get in front of a group of people to be seen as you call yourself preaching the word. No. You tell the people the goodness of God. Let Christ Jesus and him crucified be your conversation when you talk to others. Whether you talk to them in person or whether you're on your Facebook. You know, every post that you post on Facebook should be glorifying Jesus Christ. Every post that you even share on Facebook should be glorifying Jesus Christ. That's why the Lord tells us to sister through that dream, focus on him. Focus on him. Our focus is him. Keep our aim, our target, our focus on him. Regardless of what the devil throws our way, our aim and focus on Jesus, and the devil cannot pull us away. Praise the living God. Again, dear heart, now, if God has been giving you supernatural encounters by hearing his word through this ministry, send me an email at exorcist@holyghostfire.us. And also, you know, go ahead and record it. A brief recording on the audio, video would be perfect. Sometimes the video may be lengthy, but get you a Dropbox account and you can send me a link. That way you won't be limited in how big that video is. You know, dear, I like to be encouraged and I like to share the goodness of God. Not just what God is doing in my life, but what God is doing in others' life too. I like to share it. I mean, how you think other people are going to get encouraged if we don't share the goodness of God? God told us to do that. Jesus told us to do that. He said, go and tell what great things God has done for you, not to keep it to yourself. Remember what he's saying, go public with it. Not to keep it private, but go public with it. You know, I mean, if I didn't go public with my testimony, my experiences, wow. A lot of you will still be calling out to Jesus. Why? Because your delivery, your salvation, your healing was tied to mine. And that's the way God did design it, dear heart. God designed it that way. He worked through human beings. Glory to his holy name. So I'm looking forward to more and more of the testimonies. Again, not just from Brother Ellis, but also from you. From you in Jesus' name. Now, I'm looking forward to my brother in Nigeria, Brother Frank. He's going to record whenever he is out in the marketplace preaching. He's going to record it. Now, it may be in his language, but that's fine. I'm still going to share it because God's going to draw someone to it that speaks his language. Or it might be in English. I don't know which language it's going to be in, but it don't matter. All I know is when I post it, God has already chosen people to be drawn to it. And that's all that matters, and they will understand it. So I'm looking forward to your testimony. Jesus said, go preach his word. Go tell it. Proclaim it. Speak it out loud. Make it your daily conversation to one another. In Jesus' name. Have a blessed day. Shalom.